Describe what happened to you on Saturday night.
Well, I'd been at my buddy Jack's house for pretty much most of the night, and when a curfew call came around and I went to head home, the second I saw my car, I just knew something was wrong. And then upon further investigation, that's when I saw what really happened.
What really happened?
Greek yogurt. Everywhere.
In all your years living in Cape, have you ever seen anything like this?
All my years, from about 1 year old to 18 years old, no, I've never seen anything like this.
Tonight, police trying to track down vandals.
Yeah, experienced a rash of car vandalism.
Car vandalism.
This is a really close-knit neighborhood here. They tell me that something like this has never happened. And when last night, around 2:30 in the morning on Sunday, somebody vandalized one of these cars.
And police have no leads into who's responsible.
So, what is your name and who are you?
I'm Ryer.
Why do you think I'm interviewing you right now?
Because everyone thinks I did it.
Did what?
The yoke. They think I chucked it.
We decided to set out to see if this was true. Did everyone think Ryer threw the yogurt? It made sense that Ryer would be the culprit. He was a known yogurt thrower and local delinquent.
Do you remember anything from the night of the incident? Yeah, so it was a regular Saturday night. Making some music in Jack's basement. You know how it is. And we went outside, and there's yogurt on Brendan's car, and I was like, who would do that? So we were thinking maybe it was the ultras from Yarmouth. They're kind of assholes, like, they might have done it. And then I was like, oh, could have been Ryer, because it's just the type of kid to do that. But then I was like, who eats yogurt and is very messy? Chris LeBron. I confronted him about it, and he was very angry, and he didn't like it, so you never know who it could be.
So who do you think would do something like this to Brendan?
Probably Ryer. I mean, he's always dossing yoga around the calf, so probably Ryer.
He has that whole yogurt throwing thing in his blood, so yeah, no, it's 100% Ryer.
Why do you think Ryer would do something like this to Brendan?
I think Ryer would do something this mean to Brendan simply because he's just such an asshole. I mean, he walks around school just roasting Brendan all day. He roasts his mustache. He roasts his fits every single day. And not only that, he physically abuses him. He knocks his books out of his hands every day between classes. I heard Ryer showed up to Brendan's eye appointment, called him Four Eyes, and just left. Like, who does that?
It seemed like the general consensus was that Ryer did it. We were ready to close the case, but we didn't have any solid proof.
Who do you think threw the yogurt?
It's definitely Ryer Spann.
Ryer, obviously.
Ryer Spann, obviously.
So, how do you know Brendan Goss?
What can I say? See him in the hallways and he's just a hater of the yoke. Hate that kid.
What do you guys think about Ryer's interest in throwing yogurt?
He just loves it.
He loves it. It's art. It's art to him.
Would he throw it at someone's car?
No, I know it's not him, because when he throws yogurt, it's for art, not for anger.
He would never do it to hurt anybody.
Yeah.
It's his passion.
Mrs. O'Brien also made sense. She's had Brendan all 4 years, and he hasn't done a bit of homework.
Brendan! Oh, I've had him for a student all 4 years, and he never did a bit of homework.
Do you have a vendetta against Brendan because of his missed homework assignments?
No, nothing like that.
Where were you on the night of the vandalism?
Vandalism? I was in Vancouver.
You were in Vancouver?
Yes, I was in Vancouver. I have an operation. I was on the operating table in Vancouver.
You had a medical procedure in Vancouver?
Yes, I did. But don't tell anybody about it, okay?
Okay.
He started to consider Mrs. O'Brien as a suspect as well. Not only has Brendan not done homework all 4 years, he hasn't even showed up to class. Her alibi didn't make any sense. Why would she be in Vancouver for one night? We decided to confront Mrs. O'Brien to see if these allegations were true, but she declined any interviews.
Mrs. O'Brien, did we ask you some more questions?
No. You guys will have to leave. I'm sorry.
All right.
No, you'll have to leave.
Suspicious. Mrs. O'Brien had heard that word was spreading around town, and she didn't want to be involved.
Yeah, the Yogue incident? It's been spreading around town.
Brendan's car is his prized possession, so when it got hit with the yogurt, needless to say, he was very upset. Next time on Cape Elizabeth Vandal.
And Ryer Span, a couple more questions?
No.
You got some yogurt there?
Hey, I want to answer any questions.
Throw the yogurt.
You can't handle it.